Good morning. Let us discuss about how to calculate the code words using cyclic codes for multiple data words. In the sense, I have 4-bit data. I'll have totally 2^16 combinations of data words. How will I calculate the cyclic code words both in systematic and non-systematic form easily? Like, it would be better if we could write the generator matrix to compute the code. And that's what we will try to do in today's class. So at the end of today's class, you will be able to determine a cyclic code word quickly, which comprises of check and data bits, both in systematic and non-systematic form using the generator matrix. We will also discuss on how to compute the parity check or the H matrix. And if possible, we will also talk about designing an encoder circuit for N, K cyclic code. Moving on, we know lengthy computations can be made simpler by expressing G of X, the generator polynomial, as a matrix and following the simple equation of linear block code, that is, V is equal to D into G. We know that G of X represents one cyclic code vector with minimum degree of N minus K. Please remember, the generator polynomial represents one cyclic code vector of minimum degree N minus K. And it is also a factor of the primitive polynomial 1 plus X bar N. Unless and until these things are satisfied, it cannot generate the cyclic code. Now, we can say that the cyclic shifts of G of X in the form X into G of X, X square into G of X, X cubed into G of X, so on, they are all factors of the same primitive polynomial. It would surely be true. If G of X is a factor of 1 plus X bar N, surely X into G of X, which represents one cyclic shift of G of X, X square into G of X, which represents two cyclic shifts, X cubed into G of X, three cyclic shifts, so on, they all would be factors of this primitive polynomial. So using this relation, we can express each cyclic shift of G of X as one row of the generator matrix, and we'll be able to write the generator matrix like this. So let me take given generator polynomial as 1 plus x plus x cubed. So when I write this as a row vector, I know to the power of x bar 0 is 1, power of x is 1, x square term is not there, 0, x cubed term is there, 1. But remember, we are using this for a 7,4 code. So I should have a code word length of 7 bits. So we will write zeros for the rest of the bits. This represents the first code vector corresponding to the generator polynomial in a cyclic code. And I can also consider this as row 1 of the G matrix. Okay, row 1 of G. Now to find row 2, I just have to cyclically rotate this right by 1 bit. How would I do it? X into G of X. If I do X into G of X, this becomes X plus X square plus X to the power of 4. So this was G of X. If I multiply with X, I'm going to get this. The meaning of this is the X bar 0 term is not there, so 0. X bar 1 term is there, 1. X square term is there, 1. X cube term is not there, 0. X bar 4 term is there. And the remaining terms which are absent, I should put zeros. Okay. So if you observe the first line and the second line, there is just one right shift or one right rotation. Remember, the rightmost bit will come and sit in the leftmost bit. So it is one cyclic shift. Similarly, x square into g of x will be x square plus x cube plus x bar 6. And when I represent it as a row vector, it would look like this. So this represents row 2, row 3. And for a 7,4 code, I should have a generator matrix of k cross n, 4 cross 7. So I need 4 rows. For row 4, I should multiply x cubed with g of x. I'll get this value. So just list all these 4 as g of x. Done. We have the generator matrix of the required size and order. Now, if I have to generate the code in non-systematic form, I'll use this generator. So if I just have to generate it in non-systematic form, simply use this generator and multiply the data vector with the generator, you'll get it in non-systematic form. This is going to give us a non-systematic form. Can you tell me why? For the simple reason that if you notice, can I clearly separate which is identity matrix and which is the parity matrix here? No. If you look at the complete matrix, I don't see the identity matrix separately either in the beginning or in the end. So when you can't separate it out like this, it will surely generate code vectors also in the non-systematic format when I multiply this generator with data. Okay. Now, how would I convert this to systematic form? How would you obtain the data, or let's say this generator matrix, in systematic form? So for systematic form, it should either be in the form IKP or PIK. Any one of these forms, we should be able to bring it. So, and we have to do this by doing only row operations. So there won't be any major changes in the matrix when I perform certain row operations. So this was our given non-systematic generator. Now, if you just observe, I can bring it to the form PIK, parity first and then identity, because if you observe the first and second row, they are already in the form of identity. These two rows are as required for an identity matrix. Only the third and fourth rows have to be modified. I should make this first bit here as zero for the third row and the first two bits as zero for the fourth row. So what operation I'll do? Wherever there is a one in a similar position, say in R1, in row one, there is a one in a similar position, I'll take it and add it to row three, and I'll replace row three with this new value. So the complete row one should be added to row three, and row three should be replaced with that. So if you observe here, I have 1 plus 0, 1 plus 0, both ones. Okay. Then 0 plus 1 is also a one. 1 plus 1 gives you a 0. 0 plus 0 is a 0. 0 plus 1 is a 1. And 0 plus 0 is a 0. So R3 is obtained as R1 plus R3. Next, for R4, getting the last row as in an identity matrix, these two bits should be made 0. In the sense, I have to add two rows to this. One row with one in this position, that is R1, should be added. R2 with a row one in second position should also be added. And I have to add both to R4. Add R1 and R2 to R4 and replace R4 with this value. So when I do that, when I add R1, R2 and R4, I will get this value as 1 plus 0 plus 0, 1, 1 plus 1 plus 0, 0, okay, 0 plus 1 plus 0, 1, 1 plus 0 plus 1, which will be 0, okay, two ones. Then 0 plus 1 plus 1, which will also be a 0. 0 plus 0 plus 0 is a 0. 0 plus 0 plus 1 is a 1. So you're able to get, I think by mistake, we have one extra column here. Some one column has become extra. I think this column. I have to remove one column. Okay. So just imagine if you can clearly see, if you do these operations, you will get back the, you'll be getting back the generator matrix. So 1 1 0 1 0 0 0 1 1 0 0, it should be 0 1 0 0. Okay, and the third one will be 1 1 1 0 0 1 0, and the last will be 1 0 1 0 0 0 1. So you're able to get the generator matrix in the standard form of parity and identity. So parity matrix in the beginning and identity matrix in the end. So whenever you multiply the given data polynomial or the data vector with this type of generator, you'll be getting the check bits in the beginning and the data bits in the end. Usually what we have done, we had identity in the beginning and parity in the end. Here we have parity in the beginning, identity matrix in the end. So you'll be generating the check bits first and then the data bits whenever we do a multiplication. You take an example, say I just want to compute for a 7,4 code, I want to compute all the code vectors of the cyclic code in systematic form. So I'll consider this generator in systematic form, which we have obtained just now, and multiply the 4-bit data word. So when I do this multiplication, you know, row into column, I'll write the linear equations. The first 3 bits will be the parity or check bits. So D1 plus D3 plus D4. This row into second column, D1 plus D2 plus D3. This into third column, D2 plus, okay, if this is a 0, this will be D2 plus D4. And these bits into the identity matrix will just give me D1, D2, D3, D4. So these are the way in which the data bits have to be combined to get the code bits. Now all we have to do, we'll make a table listing the different combinations of the data word, starting with all 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 1 0 till 1 1 1 1. So all the 16 combinations we have listed, and we have used this basic equation to the linear equations to compute the code word. So the cyclic code will be obtained like this. Okay, the code bits V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, V6, V7. The last 4 bits will be same as data bits. The first 3 bits will be computed as a linear combination of data bits based on this parity matrix, which we have in this case. So this is easy for us. We can do it very quickly, rather than the earlier method, which we did in the last class, where I have to do polynomial multiplication when I have to get the vector, code vector in non-systematic form, and I have to do multiplication and division when I have to get the code vector in systematic form. Okay, so this would become very easy, just multiplication with the matrix, which will simply help you. Once you write them as linear equations, just compute and list it, it would turn out to be much, much faster. Okay. Next is the H matrix. So how do we obtain the H matrix? Even this is quite a simple technique. We know that the product of the generator polynomial and the parity check polynomial is nothing but the primitive polynomial x power n plus 1. Now, if h of x is a factor, if this h of x is a factor of x power n plus 1, which it is a factor, then I can say x to the power of k into h of x inverse should also be a factor of x power n plus 1. We can prove it by considering some values if you want, but as of now, we'll just take it as a fact because we have already checked it out. Okay. So x bar k into h of x inverse will also be a factor of this primitive polynomial, and cyclic rotations of this term, that is x bar k into h of x inverse, x bar k plus 1 into h of x inverse, x bar k plus 2 into h of x inverse, x bar k plus 3 into h of inverse, all these will also be factors of what? Will also be factors of x bar n plus 1, the primitive polynomial. So using this rule, let us try to first find h of x from g of x. If g of x is given as 1 plus x plus x cubed, I should divide the primitive polynomial x bar n plus 1 with g of x to get the value of h of x. And we know the long division method we have done. If I take x bar 7 plus 1 and divide it with x cube plus, usually we'll keep it in this order, x cube plus x plus 1. I'll go on. First time I should multiply with x bar 4. I'll get the value as x bar 7 plus x bar 4 plus x bar 5. And this goes off. What is left is x bar 5 plus x bar 4 plus 1. And next, to get x bar 5, I will multiply this highest term with x square. So when I multiply, so plus x square here, when we do it, likewise, you go on doing it till you get 0 as the remainder. And whatever you have as the quotient, this represents your parity check polynomial h of x. Okay. So the parity check polynomial is given as the quotient. When we divide the primitive polynomial x bar n plus 1, x bar 7 plus 1 in this case, with the generator. Once I have this, let me find h of x inverse. How do I find h of x inverse? H of x inverse is, in place of x, I have to put x inverse. So I'm going to get x bar minus 4, x bar minus 2, x bar minus 1 plus 1, or 1 by x bar 4. I can write x bar minus 4 as 1 by x bar 4, 1 by x bar 2 plus 1 by x plus 1. Okay. Now, I have to compute first x bar k into h of x inverse. What is k? It is a 7 comma 4 code. K is 4. So x bar 4 into h of x inverse. When I multiply this, okay, with x bar 4, I'm going to get the value as 1 plus x bar 4 by x square is x square plus x cubed plus x bar 4. Now, if I find the coefficients of this vector, that would give me the first row of the parity check matrix, H matrix. So this is R1 of H matrix. Okay. See, the coefficient of x bar 0 is 1, x is 0. X square is 1, x cubed is 1, x bar 4 is 1, and two more zeros to be added, because the order of H matrix should be what? N minus k cross n. Please remember all these. The order of H matrix should be 3 cross 7 in this case. So I should have 3 rows. Now, to get the second row, I will take the right cyclically shifted version of this. That is x bar k plus 1 into h of x inverse. That means this vector, whatever you have got, with one cyclic rotation. This bit will come to the leftmost and everything gets right shifted by one bit. So you'll get this value as this whole thing multiplied with x would be x plus x cube plus x bar 4 plus x bar 5. And the coefficients would be the same vector, but with one right shift. Okay. Similarly, so this will give you row 2 of H. And to get row 3, I should take x bar k plus 2. X bar k plus 2 into H of x inverse, which will give me this value. And whether you write it or not, this vector right shifted by one bit. One bit right shift. Okay. will give you the third row, 0010111. So now I have three rows in the H matrix, and the H matrix is complete. But again, if you notice, this H matrix should have been in the form IN minus K and P transpose, because G was P and IK, right? We in generator, we had parity first and then the identity. So H should be represented as identity first and then the parity transpose. But you can't make out that separation here. I can't see the identity matrix. But if you observe this, first three columns and the rows, you can clearly see that only one bit is not aligning with an identity. So by row operations, if I add row 1 to row 3 and put it back in row 1, so you add R3 to R1, that means this 1 should get added to 1 and it should become a 0, and you put it back in R1, you'll get the systematic form. See, this identity matrix should be of order 3, and the parity transpose matrix should be of order 3 cross 4, 3 rows and 4 columns. So you can observe this just by looking at this part. You can clearly say only one bit is not in order. So if you do this operation, you'll get the right form of the H matrix. R1 plus R3, put it in R1, you'll get I3, and the next will be P transpose. And we know H matrix is useful, or the H transpose matrix is useful for error detection and correction. Hence, we'll be able to find the H transpose matrix for a cyclic code easily, which we can use in error detection as well as correction. So, at the end of these classes, we have understood the basic concept of cyclic codes, the last class and this put together, how to find a code word comprising of check and data bits in systematic and non-systematic form using cyclic codes, and for fast computation of a cyclic code for a set of data, how we can write the G and H matrices and use them for computation of data. So with this, we will end today's session. Let's continue with the encoder circuit hardware in the next session. Thank you.